Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the family that is your church. And we pray that the presence of Christ, his love and forgiveness in our lives, will help us to overcome whatever barriers may exist, whatever discomforts may exist between us as your people. And we pray that our lives would reflect the joy and generosity of your Son to the world who needs you. In Jesus' name, amen. Through his people, God impacts relationships. We've been covering last week and this week the measures, we call them, the influence we hope that being a part of the community of faith will have on our lives, and the influence that this community of faith will have on the lives of others. We talked about the first one being to submit to God, to live under God's authority. We talked about the need to live honorably as a way of bearing witness to Christ and bringing glory to his name. We talked about being rooted in Scripture because we believe that the Scripture is the authoritative word of God. But as we think about the values of the last two measures of generosity and contagious joy, we find that it's critically important to understand that those characteristics are rooted in understanding God's love for us. When we're embraced by God's love, when we understand that love from God overcomes the sins and the brokenness of our lives, that God loves us and will continue to love us and will continue to care for us, it sets us free to be a people of generosity and a people of joy, especially in times of scarcity and struggle. Psalm 23 is one of the great expressions in Scripture that talk about the care of God for his people. The Lord is my shepherd. A shepherd protects and cares and provides for the sheep. As I was looking at that text this week, it dawned on me that there are numerous little snippets of wisdom that are built into this great psalm that many of us have memorized. I have all that I need is the language of the contemporary translation. I shall not want is how most of us memorized that years ago. I have all that I need. That's an abundance mentality. An abundance mentality that actually gives birth to a generous life. When we know that we have all we need, we're much freer to give and share with others. Why do I have all that I need? Because God renews my strength. How often in your life have you been at a place when you're just tired? You're just worn out. Maybe you're even sick. And it's just like, I'm not going to make it today. We have a God who renews our strength. And we trust him. We have a God who guides us along the right paths. How often in our lives are we in the midst of doing something and we're just wondering, is this really the right thing? Did I make the right decision? I personally really struggle when I'm in teams and leadership groups that are constantly looking back going, did we make the right decision? I want to say, you made the decision. Let's move on. Let's live it. Now, obviously, if you clearly made the wrong decision, you need to make a new decision. But to constantly be second-guessing ourselves just robs us of confidence and strength to move forward. We need to make decisions trusting that God is indeed guiding us and directing our paths. And often we wonder, can my life really bring honor to God? Can what I do and the way I act really reflect anything of the goodness and wonder of God? Well, our God promises He is at work in you. He is at work through you. And that through you, He will bring honor to His name. You've been given the place of privilege in your life to live in such a way that you bring honor to Almighty God. It is a great thing. I have all that I need. I will not, not I am not, I will not be afraid. Fear paralyzes us so often in our lives. Fear can control us in ways that are terribly destructive. Well, why will we have no fear? Because God is close beside me. I'm not alone. God is with me. I don't need to be afraid because Almighty God is present with me every step of every day. I am not alone. Almighty God is accompanying me. Therefore, I will not be afraid. And that God protects me and comforts me. I can step behind Him when I need to. I can feel His embrace to comfort and encourage. He prepares a feast for me. See, God knows what you and I need in our lives. And even if we can't see it, that feast is just ahead. We can count on God's provision to give us strength, to give us provision as we continue to move forward in His guidance. We don't have to worry about tomorrow because a feast lies ahead. It is indeed being prepared for us such that our cup overflows. We have all that we need. Our cup overflows. I, you, and I have plenty to share of the goodness of God that is poured out into our lives. There's no need to pull it in and hold it close. It actually multiplies as we give it away. The disciples came to Jesus and he said, we got to send these people away. They got to go get something to eat. And Jesus, according to the disciples, I think Jesus goes a little bit haywire and goes, oh no, you feed them. And they're going like, are you kidding? It would take months to come up with enough to feed these people. Well, how much do you have? Now I want you to know at this point, the disciples are encouraged. How much do you have? Oh, we'll show him how much we have. That'll set him straight. Then he'll know that we need to send them away. They come back, see? We've just got 5 loaves and 2 fish. That's maybe enough for us. We only have enough for us is the translation of 5 loaves and 2 fish. They are 12 people. 13, count Jesus. 13 people, 5 loaves and 2 fish, a fairly meager snack. We just have enough for ourselves, Lord. And Jesus says, give it to me so that you can give it to them. Our blessings overflow. And therefore, because of God's provision, because we know it, because it's been promised, because we trust in that provision, we have as a measure, something that we want to see reflected in our lives, a generosity. I give cheerfully and I live with contagious joy. I give cheerfully. Ephesians 2 says this, you are citizens along with all God's holy people. You are members of God's family. Together, we are His house. Do you know how many hands, how many skills, how many insights, and how many hours were shared just to build the building? Just to remodel the building? I know that that all of you really know this, and I know that it goes without saying, but I'll just make it abundantly clear, I couldn't do it. I know, Frank, you know that. I just don't have the skill set. How often in our lives do we evaluate what we can do, how much we can do for others, based on what we alone have? How often in ministries do we decide what activity we can do based on the committee's ability or based on the current item in the budget? And how often has this church blown that away by bringing in more people, their gifts, their generosity, their abilities, and totally exceeded any expectations that the original team had as to what they can do? Together, we are the house of God. Together, we are his people. Together, we can give incredibly generously. Built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets and the cornerstone of Christ himself. You see, we don't do what we do. We aren't who we are because of us. It's on the foundation of what has been laid before us. We stand on that firm foundation. It's on the foundation of what God is at work doing in and through us. It isn't about whether or not you can do it. It's about whether or not we can do it with God's help, according to his guidance, for he will supply us with all that we need, and we can give generously and live joyfully. Two elements motivate us to give cheerfully. I almost went here with the kids, but I'm glad I didn't. I was going to ask the kids, do you like to share your toys? I had no idea what kind of response I would get. I know in my house, when I was little, I loved to share my toys with my best friends. I did not like to share, I'm sorry, you can plug their ears if you want. I did not like to share my toys with my brothers because they abused my toys. See that little attitude? You kind of pick up on the little attitude there? The truth is, one of the dimensions of knowing, of being able to give cheerfully, is that we give cheerfully to those we love. It's a joy to share with those whom we love. Don't you love giving gifts that delight those you love? It is just wonderful. We can give cheerfully also when we know that God will provide so that we don't need to fear that we won't have enough to meet our needs. In college, I lived in this little modular unit, and there were four of us guys in the modular unit, and we had our own kitchen, which means we had our own refrigerator. Are you imagining it with me now? Open the refrigerator, and you know what you see? Labels. This is my milk. That is Darrell's milk. Now, what happens when someone comes over and I don't have enough milk? I gladly share Darrell's milk. Have you noticed sometimes it's just easier to share other people's stuff? It's easier to spend other people's money? One of the principles of living generously is an understanding that you don't own anything. That nothing that you have is yours. It, in fact, all belongs to God. We are stewards of what God has provided for us. We use the stuff that God provides for us to bring honor to his name. we use what God provides to us to share his love, to make his goodness known to those who don't know him. Almost by definition, that means we share it. We give it away. We put it to use to bless other people. And I know that the vast majority of you sitting here today know the joy of what it means to be able to bless other people. Our team, our mission team in Haiti is on the road or in the air. They're on their way back. They arrive home in Phoenix around 8 o'clock tonight. And the generosity of this community meant that 10 different families were given a set of goats as a part of the provision for the village that they served when they were in Haiti. 10 families received a set of goats. Now, this is the way that works in Haiti with Mission of Hope. The goats, male and female, usually have kids. Precisely. The first kids born of those two goats are given back to the Mission of Hope so that they can be given to another family. For the first year, the family that receives the goats is not allowed to eat them. Do you know why they're not allowed to eat them? Because eaten goats don't produce baby goats. There are no kids. They have this principle in place. But then after a year, they're given autonomy. They're told they can do whatever they want because the goats are now theirs. It moves from the place of, I'm giving you these two goats to steward them for the Mission of Hope, to now they are your goats to do with as you please, hoping that as they've stewarded them, they now know how best to use them for the sake of their community, for the sake of their village and their family. We give more cheerfully when we know that what we have belongs to God, and when we know that God has called us to love those who will receive them. Maya Angelou said this, when we give cheerfully and accept gratefully, everyone is blessed. So those of you that have poured your heart into this place to use your skills and abilities and have the great joy of giving, I also want to challenge you to remember that this community is ready to give to you when you need. When you need help, when you're struggling in some way, this community is ready to reach out to you. And I want to say to you, accept it. Be a receiver of gifts as well as a giver of gifts, and all of us will be blessed. Value 5 is continuing the legacy of faith. Aren't those cute people? Anybody recognize who those cute people might be? That was a while back. You might not recognize Paul and Kristen in those pictures. Marilyn's hardly changed. We, yeah, really smooth. Our lives change when we have children. We learned just a couple weeks ago that our daughter Kristen is expecting a child around Valentine's Day next year. Looking forward to seeing her later this week. Their lives are about to change radically. Marilyn just had a birthday, and naturally the kids said happy birthday and usually included nice statements about their mom. And Marilyn responded, greatest joy of life is to be a parent to you. I know very few parents who don't feel that way, even those that have tough kids. The greatest joy. Now, by the way, in case you hadn't noticed, it's also the greatest demand, right? I mean, kids demand a whole lot, but we give it with great joy because of the love we have for them. And so we want them to have the strength and the hope and the confidence that faith provides. We want them to journey through every day knowing that God loves them, knowing that God is with them, knowing that God will protect and provide for them. That it's not about scratching out everything for themselves. We want them to know that the church is here to support and encourage them, not simply mom and dad, but this whole community that they're a part of. It's one of the great joys of being the church. And so measure four, which comes from the value of continuing the legacy of faith, is living with contagious joy. How do you like it when mom and dad are not happy? Not good. But when mom and dad are joyful, life is good. Does faith make a difference in your home? Do your children see that joy in your life that comes through faith extends beyond the circumstances of life? Not that you're never upset, not that you're never down, not that you never discipline, but rather that you have this overarching joy that says, it's okay. Or are you like a young Jim Cortz who just kind of freaks out when things don't go the way you expect them to go? You see, all these principles that we're talking about have to do with the fact that it impacts our relationship. The fact that you know that God provides, the fact that you know that God is watching over your children allows you to respond differently to them with confidence, not with defensiveness, with a trust in God rather than a fear. And so today we're baptizing Owen Alexander. And what we're saying is, God, he's in your hands. God, he's your child to protect him and care for him. We recognize we have the stewardship to be parents to him. But we have the confidence to live out his entire life trusting that he's also a child of God being watched over. And it gives us great encouragement. And so as we continue a legacy of faith, we live with contagious joy. Each day of our lives, we make deposits in the memory banks of our children. Each day of our lives, we make deposits in the memory banks of our children. Chuck Swindoll. Charles Stanley said this, in giving us children, God places us in a position of both leadership and service. He calls us to give up our lives for someone else's sake, to abandon our own desires and put our children's interests first. Yet according to his perfect design, it is through this selflessness that we can become truly fulfilled. Parents, can I get an amen? God is good. Then Jesus says, let us go off by ourselves to a quiet place and rest a while. Being a parent can be exhausting. Can I get an amen? Amen. Stephen Covey's in Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, one of the seven habits is sharpen the saw. Jesus recognized when he had sent out his disciples to serve that they needed to find a quiet place to rest a while so that they could go out and serve again. We need, and I don't do as I do here, I'm still learning, I'm hoping I'm about to learn a little more about this. How can we live in a rhythm of life so that our saw is sharp, so that we are strong and rested and ready to give and provide and serve those around us. It happens as we recognize that Jesus says, on the seventh day, rest. Care for yourself. Don't run on the ragged edge thinking you're going to be at your best when more gets demanded of you because of the family or the people around you and something happens. Don't always trying to be dipping off the bottom of the barrel to have just that last ounce of energy to care for others. Take care of yourself so that you are overflowing in your giving to others, so that you're not putting on a smile, you're wearing the smile that comes from the joy and peace of the presence of God. Thanks be to God. Amen.